Good morning, and thanks so much for joining us for Wake Up Charlotte to Go. I'm Carolyn Bruck. Let's send things over to Larry Sprinkle for a check of the forecast. Larry.
Good morning. We have in the forecast, we have areas of fog this morning. We've seen a lot of dense fog, especially down in South Carolina. Mild again today, tomorrow, and then a very cold weekend. It'll be dry weather, but very chilly temperatures. For today, hour by hour, noontime, we're at 48 degrees. Some sun for the afternoon. Temperatures in the 50s. Right around 47 degrees around 7 o'clock tonight. For today, high temperatures for the most part should be in the low to mid 50s locally, and the mountains will be in the upper 40s there as we check your 7-day forecast. Today's high temperature near 55, areas of fog this morning. We're at 56 tomorrow, then Friday clouds in, only a very slight chance of rain, but it will be a mainly cloudy day with highs in the low to mid 50s. This weekend, be prepared. It's going to be dry weather. It's going to be clear skies, but it's going to be cold temperatures. In fact, the low Sunday morning should be about 25 degrees. We stay below average as we get into the beginning of next week. MLK on Monday, 48. We're back to the low 50s by Tuesday of next week. And that's your first one forecast, Carolyn.
Larry, thanks so much. Let's take a look at some of the top stories of the day. Right now, Mecklenburg County under new COVID-19 safety guidelines.
Based on the number of cases of COVID-19 in Mecklenburg County, Health Director Gibby Harris is urging everyone to only do essential items. That means going outside if you're an essential worker or picking up food or things of that nature. Also wearing a mask and staying away from others. She says we need to do this at least for the next 3 weeks.
Good morning. I'm Billie Jean Shaw in South Carolina. Starting today, people age 70 and up could book an appointment for the COVID-19 vaccine in South Carolina. It doesn't matter if you have a pre-existing health condition and you do not have to be a South Carolina resident. One thing to know is that you cannot book your appointment through the health department, the state health department. You have to go online to this interactive map, find the location nearest to you, and then contact information will be available so you can make your appointment through that specific location.
The plan for CMS students still up in the air this morning. The Board of Education calling an emergency meeting for tomorrow to discuss if the district should stay fully remote. Right now, CMS is scheduled to bring students back into the classroom on Tuesday.
I'm Tracy Potts. Impeachment. It's happening here in Washington today. We could see a final vote by mid-afternoon. The House managers, the Democrats essentially serving as prosecutors, have already been named to make the argument that the president incited that riot last week. The question now, what happens when all of this lands in the Senate? At least five Republicans have said so far they will vote with Democrats today, yes, on impeachment.
Time now to connect the dots when we make the news make sense. Japan, now the latest country to find a new COVID strain. Two other new strains have also emerged from the UK and South Africa in recent weeks. And while this sounds scary, it's actually perfectly normal behavior for a virus. Here's Ben Thompson.
The coronavirus continues to mutate. There are now several new strains around the world. Some are even more contagious. The scientists say it's not a surprise. Let's connect the dots. All viruses mutate. As a virus spreads, it makes copies of itself. Over time, that changes the virus. Typically, mutations don't happen as quickly as they are right now. But because the coronavirus is spreading so fast, the virus has even more chances to mutate. Here's the good news. Researchers say there's no evidence that these new strains cause more severe symptoms. They're also confident vaccines will protect against all these COVID variants. And that is connecting the dots.
Ben, thank you. Good morning, everybody. The NBA is trying to finish out their season, but they've got more and more players testing positive for COVID-19 and dealing with issues with the virus when it comes to the protocols they have in place. As of today, this morning, we know that at least five games have been postponed or canceled this week. And 36 players, that was as of yesterday, are dealing with virus-related issues or protocols. The NBA and Players Association, they came together, they created some new rules that are going to be in place for the next 2 weeks, hopefully to get through. Players can't go anywhere outside of their homes or hotel rooms when they're on the road, except for practice and games. The new rules also limit team meetings to 10 minutes in the locker room before games, and players are going to have to wear masks on the sidelines at all times. In addition to those safety guidelines, they're also ramping up testing. Now, we're hearing some players are not on board with this, like Oklahoma City Thunder guard George Hill. He says, right here in the quote, if it's this serious, maybe we shouldn't be playing. But the league is hoping it doesn't come to that. Of course, we want to know what you think. Remember, the bubble was really successful for the NBA. But on the other hand, the NFL didn't have to do that, and they carried out a season. Another thing to note is that the Dallas Mavericks have been one of the hardest hit teams by this virus as they've tried to do the season. And they are right here in Charlotte now to play the Hornets tonight. So we'll continue to keep everybody posted. Back to you.
The good news about this is there is a light at the end of the tunnel. Vaccinations have started. So hopefully this will not be the same conversation we are having next year. Rachel, thanks. Make sure you watch us every single morning starting at 4:30 a.m. on Wake Up Charlotte. Have a great day.